In this video, we will cover specifics of making split-level houses. The principle of creating split-level houses is identical for Mac, Windows, and iOS versions of the app. Once you master split-level for one version, you will easily create them in others. The story height is controlled via the Building Properties tab of the Inspector. Unfortunately, we do not have the ability to change it for each room individually, but there is a walkaround through the usage of 2D tools and Object Properties tab of the Inspector. Let's consider the first case, when two rooms are adjacent one to another, but there is a small difference in their levels. Use the project tree, or simply tap on the floor to select it. Then open Inspector, Object Properties tab, and change the elevation to a negative value. Now select the ceiling and change the elevation by deducting the same value to compensate the difference. Then remove moldings for each wall individually. This can be done through the Object Properties tab of the Inspector. To speed up the process and remove all moldings at once, select an entire room on 2D plan. After that, we paint the lower part to match the color of the rest of the wall. It is important to know that you may lower the floor as long as you have a foundation underneath. If you need to lower it deeper, simply make the foundation higher using the Building Properties tab. With this technique, you can create something similar to a house Model 2 in our template gallery. What we have here are two rooms sitting on a foundation which equals 80 centimeters. The floor in the garage was lowered to a ground level. Let's see what other techniques for making split-level houses we have. If the difference in levels is bigger, you'll not be able to compensate it with the ceiling and floor elevation controls. This is when ceiling opening tool in 2D view comes in handy. Say if you have a room with a height of 4.5 meters and another adjacent room, which height is 3 meters. Here's what you should do. Create two rooms with the lowest room height, in our case, 3 meters. Use the Building Properties tab of the Inspector to add a second story with the height that equals the difference between room heights minus the slab thickness. 4.5 minus 3 minus 0.20 equals 1.3. Create a ceiling opening to merge lower and upper rooms to create a single room with 4.5 meters in height. Note that you need to be on the ground floor to create this opening. All we should do now is remove the molding for each wall and paint slabs.
Another scenario with split levels is when you have two adjacent rooms with the roof above them. Something like that. Here's what you can do to create such house. Create two rooms on the 2D plan. Using the Building Properties tab of the Inspector, add a second story. With the help of the Straight Wall tool, add a missing wall between two rooms on this story. Add an auto roof. We'll use hip roof as an example. Select the room which should have a lower roof. Then, using the Object Properties tab of the Inspector, change the type of its three walls to loft. The adjacent wall should remain as is. Make sure the loft walls do not intersect with it. As you can see in 3D, the roof appeared only above the room which does not have loft walls. To add it for the second room, add an auto roof on the current story. Switch to Object Properties tab of the roof and set the necessary elevation for it. Here we go. If a part of the roof appeared inside the adjacent room, you may remove it by reducing the overhang volume. The possibilities for roof editing are almost endless, especially if you have access to the custom roof tool in the Pro version. But this is a story for another tutorial. Well, that's it for our short tour on split-level houses.